Hi friends, welcome to Legal Bites, an initiative taken by the Legal Aid Society of G.R. Kari College of Law, Margaon, Goa. I am Nelly Falcao, a third year BA LLB student of G.R. Kari College of Law, Margaon, Goa. Today, I'll be talking to you about permanent commission to female officers in the Indian Army. Now, permanent commission is a career in the Army till you get retirement. But of course, you can take voluntary retirement at any age. Now, whether permanent commission was to be granted to females or no was a matter of debate. And unfortunately, permanent commission was only granted to men. A career in the army comes with many trials. And especially, it becomes even more difficult for females when the society puts pressure of childcare and domestic work. Here, we must remember that the structure of our society has been created by males for males. Earlier, females were barred from serving the force for more than 14 years. Well, recently, a year before, in the case of the Secretary, Ministry of Defense versus Babita Punya and others, in this case, the Supreme Court ruled that permanent commission is now to be granted to female officers, rejecting the government's stand on their physiological limitations based on sex stereotypes and gender discrimination. In February 2003, Babita Punya, an advocate, instituted a writ petition in the form of a public interest litigation to grant permanent commission to the SSC women officers. About 332 female officers had approached the apex court on the issue of granting permanent commission to female officers, and the issue of command postings also came up in the discussions. About 60 women officers alleged that they were denied permanent commission on the grounds of their medical fitness. The Supreme Court said that the requirement of medical fitness to get permanent commission for the female officers was completely arbitrary and irrational. However, the female officers must be considered for permanent commission subject to their disciplinary and vigilance clearance. The court directed that within 3 months of the judgment, all the serving SSC women officers have to be considered for permanent commission, irrespective of them having crossed 14 years or 20 years of their service as the case may be. And SSC women officers with over 20 years of their service who have not been granted permanent commission shall retire on pension. Thank you.